Hello and welcome, ladies and gentlemen. This is JTV showing of Battle of the Classes here at Jackson Memorial High School, in which each graduating class will be competing in a variety of games to determine who is the best graduating class of this school year. So we have a variety of games. We have 7 events, and we'll come back after our national anthem. And might I say, the tension and energy in this stadium, in this basketball court right now is palpable, which is interesting considering that typically these events have been dominated by the juniors and seniors, the upperclassmen, but from what I'm seeing right now, the freshmen really getting into it, sophomores as well, everyone getting into it. As you can see, everyone down on the court, chest bumping, giving each other high fives, getting crazy. And of all the Battle of the Class events I've been to, I don't think I've ever seen energy that matches this. So each class will be represented by their color. The seniors at the top left of your screen will be represented in pink. Sophomores in blue. Juniors in blue. Sophomores in green. And freshmen in yellow. And it is time for our first event of the evening, musical chairs. Each graduating class will be sending out 2 boys and 2 girls. As the seniors really getting into it early. Here we go. As all the players are getting set for our first events, and we are away. Let's see, Angelo Nicosia In anticipation, he's already got his hand in the chair. Here we go. It's everyone's just inching right now, waiting for the music to stop. Oh, we got a shove there. Okay. Oh, look at this. The tension's palpable. Hey, we got a sit down, and I believe a senior and a junior eliminated in the first round. And wait, there was a seat available, and one of the seniors sits back down. Incredible. We're going to take a second look at that, a miscommunication of some time, as you see the sideline of the seniors really getting into it. Incredible. Talk about an opening round as we start the second round. Here we go. And we got a quick stop here. Everyone's sitting down, and we've got elimination. Angelo Nicosia pulled down one of the sophomores into a chair, and that's going to eliminate one of the junior members. We will take a second look at this. She got up, and the round wasn't over, which I believe is what happened in the previous round. Miss McCann is trying to get everyone moving in an orderly fashion. Is dropping. Looks like we have a little bit of a stoppage on the line. And as you see, everyone is cutting during the kind of break between the seats because they don't want to be caught in that spot. And we got to stop. And looks like we have no eliminations. Oh, one of the junior class member has been eliminated, and Aiden Sweeney pointing him off to the sideline. As we eliminate yet another chair. Wrong replay. Actually, that's right replay. Look at that. He tried to play cool. Oh, we had a quick stop, and everyone's down. And it looks like Nicosia, Angelo Nicosia has been eliminated. Oh, man. And Nicosia not happy about that. We have three more seniors left. As it looks like we only have three more seniors left and only one more junior left. That's Lorenzo Azzaroni. As the music starts again. Look at this. Got a bit of shoving in the line here. And we got everyone sitting down, and we got an elimination. That one from the freshman class. We will take a second look at that. Very clean. A lot of the time they'll try and finesse their way into a spot, but didn't even work. Here we go. Seniors getting loud as we start once more. Oh, got a bit of fighting in the back end. We got to stop. And Azzaroni has been eliminated. And that is all for the junior class of 2024 as they are the first class eliminated. And the seniors are happy about that. Ms. McCann eliminates another seat as the music starts once more. Every second, the players get a bit more jumpy. We gotta stop, and we've got an elimination. And that appears to be a member of the sophomore class, and there was a spot open. Aiden managed to take it. We'll take a second look at that. Aiden initially didn't find a seat, but once one opened up, he managed to go find it as we got another stoppage, and we got another elimination. As now the freshman class is dropping like flies. Here we go. Only a handful left, mostly seniors. Here we go. wipe your seats, and it looks like another freshman heads over to the bench. As now only a handful of players remaining. As we take a second look at it. Yeah, she just caught in a bad spot, but a good job. Oh, good job there on the edge. To steal the seat from her, she was on top of it. And we got another stoppage. And we got in front of the seats. And looks like a member of the sophomore class is eliminated. That only leaves, I believe, two sophomores left and three seniors. As the seniors are looking to claim this first challenge. Aiden O'Donnell is getting more and more jumpy with every round. As to be expected, gotta fight for seats, and O'Donnell is out! And then there were only two seniors remaining. We'll take a second look at it, and again, just a bad position. There's a lot of luck that comes into this. Here we go. Five remaining. Two seniors. And another senior eliminated! Only one senior remains. As again, unlucky. So not only can you get caught out of the area of the seats, but you can also get caught between seats. Three seats remaining, and that's it. We got two sophomores, one freshman, and one senior. Here we go! And we've got another elimination! And then there were three, only two chairs remaining. One of each class. One senior, one freshman, and one sophomore. Here we go. As they're rotating the chairs at an incredibly fast rate. Could be risky. Here we go. And we got a stoppage! And the seniors eliminated! Seniors are out! And we'll take a second look at this. Again, it caught in an unfortunate position with only two seats just on the edge. Just no chance for her to get a seat. One seat remaining, and it is the two lower-classmen, one freshman, one sophomore, to decide our first game of the evening. Here we go. And they are bobbing and weaving around the seats in anticipation of the music stopping. Here we go. And we gotta stop. And freshman taken! Oh, there's a fight for the seat! There's a fight for the seat! The crowd is storming the field. Who's got it? And I believe it is the freshman. Are you kidding me? Graduating class of 2026, the underdogs take the first game of the evening. Incredible. And they're going crazy. I would love to get a second look at that final play. Wow, what a turbulent ending to a game. And we will take a second look at this one. And a good effort on both sides, and they do give it to the freshman. Incredible, what an opening game. And like I said before, normally these games are dominated by the upperclassmen, junior and senior, but the final two remaining were freshman and sophomore. So that shows all the parity that's gonna be in this and how competitive these teams are. They're not gonna make it easy on these upperclassmen. As we move to our second game, basketball. So each graduating class will send out two players, one boy and one girl, and they will have 1 minute to shoot a layup, free throw, three-point, and a half-court shot. And the first to complete will win. And then following our second event of basketball, we will have the freshman dance. And in every two subsequent events, we will have the next graduating classes dances. So after event four, we'll have the sophomore dance. After event six, we'll have the junior dance. And then finally, after the eighth event, we will have the senior dance. As the seniors discussing with themselves on their sideline, thinking they're not making this easy on us, these lower classes, so it's going to be really competitive. So we'll see what they do. Maybe they bring their A game in the second of our matches this evening after coming in third place in the first. So we'll see who they send out. And I believe they're deciding which two to send out. A number of players from the basketball team currently present. Charlie Meglio potentially will be sent out.
So freshman number first.
Aiden O'Donnell as well.
You have 1 minute. You each have to make a layup, a free throw, a three-point shot, and a half-court shot.
And I believe the way this will be structured, they're going to put two classes up against each other at one time. All right, and it looks like first up, he'll be our freshman.
All right, Rick. On your mark. Get set.
They're on a one-minute time limit. Layup is good. Now to the free throw line. Takes a second. Not, and he's off. Up for his second. Shot is bricked. Trickady hit one. Oh, for three. The clock is ticking. We are at 30 seconds already. And he misses again. Not looking good for the freshman as they switch assignments. Her first free throw. No. They're 0-4. 0-5. They can't hit a free throw. 0-6. They still can't hit one. Only ample time left. They only have a few seconds left. From three. 20 seconds left. Oh, the first attempt. You're kidding me. They have a chance. If they can hit one from half court, she launches it. No good. 10 seconds.
Eight, seven, six,
last one. Five. Last chance. Oh, you're kidding me. Oh, my God. These freshmen came to play. Oh, man. As they complete the challenge. Man. Talk about a buzzer beater after missing six or seven free throws consecutively. Even I thought there was no shot, but man, they hit the 3-point shot of the first attempt and then only taking two attempts to hit the half-court shot. Incredible. As our sophomore class, hard act to top. Let's see if they can complete the challenge.
All right, Rick. Are you on? Get set. Are you on? Get set. Go.
And we are off. First attempt at the left's no good. Misses her second. Not a good start. Misses her third. Her fourth. Can't she get one? And she missed again. Finally knocks it down. They'll switch players. Already half the time has been consumed. Misses the first free throw. Now for the second. No good. Bricks it. Third attempt. Third time's a stop. No good. Man. Shots up. No good. As the free throws have been a struggle for both sides early on. Here we go. 20 seconds left. Looking for three. Bang! And now they have a decent bit of time to hit that half-court shot. They'll switch players. 10 seconds left. This might be their only shot. Here we go. It's not good. Oh, wait. They might get one more off. Buzzer beater. No good. And the sophomores have been eliminated. And that is rough. Coming off a rough stretch of layups and then the free throws as well. They could have saved themselves a lot of time to get to that half-court shot. I believe the freshmen got lucky that they hit on the second attempt. Not quite as lucky as now. Here are the junior class. Knocks down the free throw in the first attempt. First free throw is no good. Number two, and it's good. Great pace as they switch players. First attempt from three. Knocks it down. And they have 50 seconds to hit a half-court shot. And no good on the first attempt. They got to run and chase. Get the rebound. They launch it. Wait. Oh, wait. And he hits the shot. It's good. Sophomores stay alive with a dominant showing. They didn't even hit the halfway point. That is how it's done. We'll take a second look at that, and I thought that he didn't fully clear half court. Controversial call, but his foot is on the line, so I do believe it's good. Now it comes down to this. The senior class is up. Here is Charles Meglio. Knocks down the first free throw. Knocks down the layup. Now for the free throw. Off the rim, no good. Attempt two. No good. Charles will step up. His first attempt. No good. Attempt two. From Charles is good. Now for 40 seconds. First attempt from three. And no good. Back out. Messer. No good. They got to make time here for the halftime. For the half-court shot. Meglio takes over from three. Bang! Now they got some time for the half-court shot.
20 seconds.
Here's Meglio. No good. Clock is winding down. 15 seconds left. Shot airballed it. Messer has to get that rebound. It's coming out of the wire here. Meglio! No good. Can they get it off? Here it is. It all comes down to this. No good. Seniors have been eliminated. As the seniors have not shown up these last two games. Eliminated. Second team eliminated. And in the first match, they came in third place. A rough showing for what was the heavy favorite coming into this one.
All right, so next up will be the freshman dance. So the rest of you should be sitting in the bleachers.
And now the freshman dance, as everyone takes a break, heads to the bleachers. As raining boos from the crowd for this freshman class, as they have had a good showing in our first two games thus far, pulling home, bringing in the victory for musical chairs, and then of course completing the challenge for basketball. Freshmen prepare for their freshman dance.
Thank you.
And hats off to our freshmen for an incredible performance with their dance. So we'll see what the other classes have to do to respond to that. But before we get to the other classes' dances, we will get to our next two events. So the next event coming up is going to be the balloon pop. So each team will be sending out four players, two boys and two girls. And they'll be having to pop their team color associated with the color that they are sporting right now. So it's interesting to see the mindset coming in this one for the upperclassmen, because right now they're both behind the eight ball right now. I believe neither of them has scored as many points as the freshman or the sophomore, so we'll see if they can rebound in the next few events, because they're going to need it if they're going to look to take home the Battle of the Classes victory. As you can see at the top of your screen, we're going to have all the balloons coming out. The preparations are being made for the balloon pop game. As you can see, a variety of colors here. Each of them are going to be corresponding to each of the colors for the classes, so seniors in pink, sophomores in blue. I'm sorry, seniors in pink, juniors in blue, sophomores in green, and freshmen in yellow. So they're gonna have to pop their balloons, and the first to pop all of the balloons will claim victory in this round. And we got an accidental pop! Oh, we got two! Looks like we got a malfunction before the game's even started. And we got a third! What is going on? As they're trying to spread the balloons throughout the gymnasium. And also trying their darndest to not pop them before the game starts. And we got another pop. What is going on? Pops going on everywhere as the seniors are assembling their team, all the sides assembling their team. So I wonder who they'll be picking for each of these rounds. All of the teams are gathering in the center with Coach Van Heys as the rest take their seats in anticipation for the result of this one. Seniors in need of a huge win. Sophomores as well in order to take over the freshmen. And then the juniors, though, sitting on the bottom, really need a win right now after a poor showing in the last few matches. And the freshmen, of course, if they take this, I mean, you winning the first three events would be huge, as we've got more pops, as I feel bad for Coach Van Heys, who's probably losing his mind at all the premature pops. Now each class is gathering in their respective corner, awaiting the signal from Coach Van Heist to begin. And we got another pop. What is going on? Oh, man.
All right.
Why? We get more reps on. No, we get more reps.
On your mark.
Here we go.
Get set. Go.
And we are off. And first comes Mikey Aaron for the seniors. Belly try to belly drop on one. Let it try to get some finesse. Mikey Aaron tags out. So do the freshmen. We got some pops. Sweeney pops a bubble. Tags in another. Really good pace for these teams as they're trying to belly flop and get him. But they're not doing a good job. Got another pop. All these sides. Moving at a great pace. Here we go. And they got to be careful to not pop any of the balloons from either of the classes, because that's going to give them the advantage. Another belly pop from Aiden Sweeney. Out to his corner. Tags in. Oh, we got pops going off. Got a nice pop in the corner here. 1 minute remaining. Struggling to... We got balloons struggling to pop over here. Freshmen and sophomores are nailing it. Time is winding down. Here comes Mikey Aaron. Oh, he missed the balloon. He missed it again. He's struggling to pop it. It has been a rough showing for the seniors so far. Aiden Sweeney gets the tag. Gets a pop. That's another tag. That's on the sideline. 20 seconds left. It is now crunch time. Here comes Liz Jam. Here we go. We got a struggle in the middle to pop some. Here we go. Jam. We got pops running down. Running at every last pop. That is going wild. It's the juniors who take it. I only see one blue bubble out there. I believe the juniors have it. Coach Van Heist and Miss McCann are counting. So we will get an official victor in just a few moments. As every single class taking a knee in anticipation, hoping that they grab the win. And it is very close. It's not a huge margin between all the classes. As Aiden O'Donnell having a word with the official. And it looks like not good news for the seniors who have struggled. And now the first three games is they had some trouble popping the balloons. Had to go for third and fourth attempts to pop some, which was a huge disadvantage, as I believe it was the juniors who won. But we'll see in a moment. We could have a tie, potentially. Between the sophomores and the juniors. Two teams that really needed to win. And as the seniors continue to plummet right now, as they have yet to win a single game. And the freshmen getting pushed. And the seniors not happy about the ruling.
Quiet, quiet, and on the ball, and
now we're going to have a competition. They're going to have one sophomore and one junior. This is for the win. It all comes down to the wire. They both rush in. And it looks like the sophomore's got it. Sophomore's got it. Oh, man. You have got to be kidding me. I got a high five, too. Let's go. Sophomores take home the win in event number 3. Their first event victory. Wow. And they needed that one, their first event victory of the day. That now puts them, they're now pushing the freshmen for the lead. I believe that puts them ahead of the juniors now. And the seniors sitting at the bottom right now, which is very interesting. Has some very serious conversations happening on their bench.
All right, you are in the tic-tac-toe event. Go to the ball over there. Tic-tac-toe event.
And we now proceed to our next event, number 4, tic-tac-toe, in which both teams will be sending out 2 boys and 2 girls. So each team, they're gonna have to run up, place an X or an O down, then run back, and then tag their teammate in. They'll run up and they can choose to move their previous move. So, and how you cannot touch other teams whenever they place their markers. So we'll see. It's gonna be a very interesting game.
Who's doing tic-tac-toe?
Seems like it's taken the teams a little extra time to assemble their lineups for this game. As you can see, the tic-tac-toe board laid there on the Jaguar logo. As all teams meet in the center with Coach Van Heist to discuss the rules. And the seniors sending out Ty Mann and Liz Chan in major need of a victory. A lot of pressure on those two, and a lot of pressure on the other teams to stay ahead of the seniors, because we're only halfway through thus far, so things can change really, really fast. So we'll see what changes. That was going to be interesting. Right. Since they can move their previous attempts, so if they place one in the center, they can move it to the corners. They get a variety of things. So we'll see how they use that rule. As now, freshman sophomores head there. Both of them place one in the middle. And they move one out to the corner. They just need to get red to the corner for a tic-tac-toe. It's no good. Oh, red. They just need one in the middle. They place one, it's blocked, and they shift the board, and it looks like we got a stoppage. And I believe the sophomores will take this opening round. Interesting, because the board did in fact move, so it may not have counted. But I believe the sophomores have claimed victory.
Ready?
Here we go. Juniors and seniors, it looks like Ty Mann will lead off with the seniors.
Go.
And we are off. Ty Mann lays one in the corner. Red will go in the left side. Liz Chan in the middle. And both teams need the top corner. And just like that, 3 moves. And we got tic-tac-toe. Ty Mann puts the dagger in the hearts of the juniors.
Juniors versus freshmen.
As finally, the seniors catch a break. But they will have to get past the freshmen in order to claim victory in this round. That was a very clean round. Corner, middle, center, no one moved, no one challenged them.
All right, Underwood, get set, go.
Juniors and freshmen, both of them go into the middle. They'll lay it down, one down in the bottom corner on the left side. All we need, we almost had tic-tac-toe there. Puts one down in the middle. And run away, they need the top corner, they block it. And they got tic-tac-toe. Freshmen beat out the juniors. As now back-to-back defeats suffered by the juniors just a few moments ago to the freshmen. And now again to the seniors, as that, I believe, will eliminate them from the competition. So I believe it will be the seniors, the sophomores. Time in leading off, and we are away. They'll go both in either bottom corner. Control in the middle. They both need a top corner. She moves it. A good move to block it. They do need that bottom for the win. And they got tic-tac-toe. Sophomores take it. They eliminate the juniors as the seniors in disbelief on the sideline. Not happy about that one. We will take a second look at it. Look at that. Seniors getting vocal, believing that one of the sophomore players is in violation of the rules, and we got a debate in the middle right now. This can decide the match right now. As now other seniors from the bench are coming over, Angelo Nicosia, Tyler DeMonico, among others, trying to plead their case. And from the looks of it, it will be a redo, I believe. I think they're going to run the round again after a potential violation of the rules. I believe it's fair. Time in leads off, and we are gone. It's the same move as last time. Oh, it's a bit of a stumble there. Good block by Liz Chan. And time in puts the last one down, and that's it. Seniors taking their first win of the day. Finally, after three games of heartbreak, they finally did it as their bleeds from the sideline pay off as they take a potential loss and turn it into a win as they snatch victory from the jaws of defeat. And they needed that.
All right, next up, sophomore dance.
And now we'll be leaving off with the sophomore dance. Let's see how they do it. They are following up a tough act to follow. This freshman, a very creative dance, a very special dance. So let's see what they have in mind. I believe we got a red carpet, I believe, on the court. Thank you. incredible performance from our sophomore graduating class of 2025, and the juniors and seniors not liking that, collectively chanting, that was awful. And I think that one comparable to the freshman performance not too long ago. As we now proceed to our fifth game of the evening, Hungry Hippos. So there's gonna be four players in each class, two boys, two girls. One scooter, one person on the scooter, another player holds a person's legs and moves the person's, and they'll grab as many balls as possible. And the other players have basket duty. You can switch players within the four that are in this event. So very interesting game. Very creative work done by our staff to create very interesting games for each of these classes to compete in. As now both sides making the preparations, we got hoops down in the gymnasium, we got balls in the middle. And we got the scooters, and I haven't seen one of those in quite a number of years. And man, they are a sight for sore eyes. And each of them, the perfect color for each side. As now the balls have been poured right now on the logo, and they will be dispersed across the entirety of the gymnasium. As both teams prepare and are creating their lineups for this upcoming event. Every single graduating class has formed their teams, and they are ready to get this next game underway of Hungry Hippos. All of the balls that they will need to be collect, that they need to collect, have been placed on the logo. All of these teams have everything to gain with a win right now. Seniors riding high after a massive win in tic-tac-toe. They got to rest watching the sophomore dance. And all eyes are on them. Let's see if they can grab a second consecutive win and really start pulling ahead of the other classes right now. Thank you. as all four teams are ready, standing in their respective corners, ready to go.
All right, ready?
Okay. And this is going to be huge for momentum. All these teams essentially in the same spot in terms of points right now. All of them, again, with everything to gain with a win. I believe we got Charles on the, going to be our hungry hippo for the seniors.
Hey, Fizz.
So as you guys may or may not know, they can rotate players throughout this. So I'm very interested to see how they plan to use the rotation and see if they if they rotate players at all. See if that hit any of the teams decide to. But what I'm noticing with a lot of these games is they're kind of formulating the strategy as they go. So I think that applies to Hungry Hungry Hippos as well as I imagine not many, not too many people playing this at home.
Get set. Go.
And we are away. And it looks like the juniors get their first. Look at that. Charles Megley have got a bunch and lost them as the balls have been spread everywhere. Interesting strategy by the sophomores as they are just spreading balls to the corner for basket duty. Look at that. Just oh, great zoning method from the sophomores here. Just pushing all the balls to their corner.
40 seconds.
40 seconds now. Neither team has really encroached on the other sides. Just look at this, the sophomores getting pulled here. And it is tight right now. Looks like all these teams neck and neck. Seniors with a good lead. Sophomores building up their pile as well. Look at this. And the sophomores have a lot. Most balls are in their zone. And as well for the seniors as they're trying to collect all of them. 20 seconds. Megalo just trying to grab every ball he can and bring it back. Looks like O'Donnell on basket duty. Nearly full. Looks like seniors got it. Oh! We've got a disqualification on the sophomores and they're not happy about that. 10 seconds left. Can the seniors close it out? And they will. Seniors got it. Seniors got it. Seniors got it. Sophomores were the only team within an earshot of the seniors, and they got disqualified in the waning seconds. That is huge. And disappointment after a really good opening round as they thought they'd take it early on. That is rough for the sophomores, but the seniors pushing the freshmen for that top spot. And I believe with one more win, they'll get there. As everyone on the sidelines getting rather restless. Between these rounds, the tension is piling. As that will conclude Hungry Hungry Hippos. Everything up from Hungry Hungry Hippos, and we will be transitioning to our sixth event of the evening, dodgeball. So every single side, they'll be sending out four players, two boys and two girls, and it's just as simple as that. It's just simple dodgeball, and they're going to be it's going to be a very simple playoff type bracket. Freshmen and sophomores, juniors and seniors will play each other. And then the next round, it's going to be losers and losers, winners and winners, until we have the one team remaining who will take this event. as all these teams essentially neck and neck, but it looks like the seniors may pull ahead with now back-to-back wins. But this one will be huge. If they pull off three consecutive event wins, that could secure it for them. As dodgeball, this could be a game that gets rather violent. A lot of energy is involved in this game, especially with the teams playing in, I guess, a tournament style. We could see the animosity really building up to the final two games of the evening. As Van Heys, Miss McCann, and the rest of the staff are preparing for dodgeball. The ball is being placed on the line. Very interesting to see who these teams will send out. We've seen a variety of players check in and out for all these sides. So let's see, maybe they want to rotate someone in new, or maybe they want to stick with a player who's won them a lot of games in order to get a potentially reliable win. Really close out, since this has been very close so far. Every class has been jarring for first since the start. As both sides formulating their four-man teams as they prepare for the next round. As the freshmen and sophomores hit the court, freshmen on your left and sophomores on your right. As they meet with Coach Van Heys in the middle, discussing the rules as they prepare to do battle in dodgeball. Both sides are now taking their spots. Van Heys with the whistle, ready to signal the start of dodgeball. We've got six balls total and eight total players, so we'll see how that dynamic works out. And we are away, a mad dash to the middle, and we've got some outs off the start. And it looks like some point in communicating. Some players that think they were hit believe they weren't hit. We've got some arguing now. And now a stoppage in the action. Looks like one of the freshmen eliminated as we resume action. That one fired, hits the hoop. Ooh, fired a little too close to the back there. As both these teams very defensive. None of them even crossed their own three-point arcs thus far. Tension tie, just no one wants to get hit right now. And to be honest, you got to get close in order to get a hit. That one, another miss. That one put on the ground. No balls left for the freshmen. Sophomores could just fire at them. I think, oh man, missed opportunity there is now the freshman with some extra ammo. That shot misses. Freshman stands up and that one into the crowd. Again, no balls for the sophomores. It's 3-on-3, and still neither of these teams willing to step up and make a play. Everyone hanging in their own backcourts. That one hits the back. That one misses. Another fires one. Woo-hoo! Almost a half-court shot right there. One of the spare balls just went past by me over here on the sidelines. No one has gotten out in the last 3 or so minutes of play. It has been an intense standoff here. Looks like it's now the sophomores who've got some ammo. They've got to find some kind of strategy. Oh, man. Someone got hit in the audience right next to me. Oh, man. Oh, dangerous hand. We've got an elimination here on the sophomore side. And she is not happy about that one. Play is still going on. One sophomore left standing. It looks like one of the freshmen brought back. As we could see an all-out assault here, everyone just fires at the same time. A coordinated assault. They all step up and fire, and they miss. We'll get a replay for now. And it looks like it is 3-1. Sophomores here, not in a good position, but he does have most of the balls on his side. He steps up and fires. It's no good on that shot. Trying to get the return, but it's no good. And they're trying to have a collective assault. All three members of the freshman class has balls. They throw it, and it might have dinged his foot. But it looks like no call there. He's safe. He's got some ammo as all the freshman class members take a seat. They all hanging in their own backcourts. He fires another one that misses. Steps up and launches one. No good. Go. Incredibly defensive, and it's going to be hard to hit someone from this spot on the court when they're from opposite parts of the court right now, considering how far the ball has to travel. And it looks like we're going to get a shortening of the playing field. Both teams will have to be playing from their own 3-point lines. Not good news for the freshmen, as some cheap shots don't hit there. And a shot there. Misses another one that goes out in the stands. And knocks down one freshman, two against one. Can he pull out the hat trick to save the sophomores? They're trying to coordinate right now. And he nails him! Game over! Game over! Freshmen take it! As the sophomores head to the loser's bracket in the first round. As the freshmen head to their respective sidelines and celebrate, take some well-deserved rest after a long round of dodgeball. And now we will see the two upperclassmen, juniors and seniors, go at it. As both sides get set. The winner of this will be sent to the winner's bracket and play against the freshmen. Losers will be sent down and play against the sophomores. And then the winner of those respective games will play in the championship to decide it all. As now the staff setting up the balls. Both teams are ready. They had a very long round last time. Both teams, they kind of just sat back in their own backcourts unless they had the ball. But since the ball had to travel so far, we didn't really get a lot of eliminations until that final phase. But we did get a lot of eliminations at the cornucopia, like to call it, right in the middle, with a lot of balls and a lot of instant eliminations. As Ty Mann, the only one up there, nearly eliminated one junior off the bat as the junior. As the freshmen control the balls. Time hand beckoning the juniors and saying, come at me. Fires one at his feet, no good. Bounce off the floor first. A lot of low balls here from both teams. That shot's no good. Both teams kind of hanging behind their own 3-point arcs right now. That one low, and that one hit me. That ball, it hit me in the leg. I'm in pain. Someone help me. Oh, man. I feel in danger right now. And we got an elimination of the juniors. And now, I believe we got an elimination on both sides. Nick Molino, I believe, got eliminated. 30 seconds remaining. 3-on-3. Shot fired there is low. Another one. Nobody home. Fires another one. Again, another miss. That one a near hit from Ty Man. That one fired low. Hits the ground first. Off the wall. It has been quite the assault. Oh, what a catch! What a catch! And now Nick Molino is back after being eliminated. It's now 4-on-2. And we got another catch! We've got another catch! And it's 4-on-1. And they're gonna sub out the one. And this is it. One man against the world. His first attempt is no good. Oh, man. Ah! I am being bombarded right now here at my little desk in the corner. I feel like I might need to relocate if this continues. It is the seniors that are controlling the tap right now. They've only had one player eliminated, and that player, Nick Molino, has been brought back against the juniors. And he got bombarded, hits the deck, and gets nailed. And that will spell doom for the juniors. Game over as the seniors advance to the next round. And we will take a second look at that one. And now we advance to the winner's bracket. It'll be sophomores and juniors. And this one to decide a placement in the final match. Which means the juniors, though, will be heading down to play the freshmen in the loser's bracket. Both teams get set. Both teams getting set. Both of these teams losers last time out. They'll be looking to rebound. It's a mad dash to the middle. And potential elimination looks like no good. Hits off the floor. And looks like bombs away early on by the underclassmen. That shot no good. Good duck there. Looks like both teams are going to back up. Just kind of calm down and survey. That one to the crowd. Might have hit off the leg. Might have hit off the leg of a sophomore there, but it looks like no good. Oh! I believe he dropped the ball as he was looking to throw it. Another shot there. That one like a roller. Oh, there's another one we got to hit, but he blocked it. Looking over to the sideline, and it looks like he's saying he's out, and he can't believe it. He's saying he blocked it. And that's one down for the juniors. Now it's 4-on-3 in favor of the sophomores. That shot no good. It looks like the sophomores. I bust the balls and he nailed him right in the chin. As now only one junior remaining. It looks like she's going to give up. That is game.
Seniors and freshmen.
Sophomores take it in the loser's bracket. And now we're on to the winner's bracket. Freshmen and seniors. The two farthest apart classes in terms of age and experience, and they're both competing in the winner's bracket. Here we go, as they both meet in the center and they decide the rules. It looks like same lineups for both squads. Seniors looking to take home a much needed win. They are on a hot streak as of late, three consecutive game wins. Here we go. Both teams are set. Van Heist ready to kick us off. And we're off. Time man again with a fast start to the center. Ooh, had a potential opportunity to get someone out. Nice block there. Look at this. The seniors firing early and often. Shot there is no good. Molino steps up and fires one. Nice jump there to dodge it. Molino is safe. Ooh, and a bit of controversy there. It's 4-on-3. Looks like we got some arguing right now about the ruling on that hit. That shot's no good. We're going to say Nick Molino's out. It's now tied up 3-3. Both teams surveying. He's trying to relax and strategize in their own backcourts. Seniors getting loud on the sidelines. But they do, in fact, control the ball, so we'll see. My man at the line. Looking to fire. Meyer fires one that's no good. Another shot there by Chloe Messer that's no good. Man barely misses his target. Looks like they're strategizing, communicating about a potential strategy. We'll see what they have in mind. And it looks like we've got an elimination by technicality. No, never mind. I just put a ball back in, ladies and gentlemen. That red ball, I put that in there. I'm contributing. Time man. Sizing up the defense. It's 2-on-2. It's Ty and Maya left for the seniors. It is incredibly tense. Ooh, Ty barely dodged that one. That one almost hit our cameraman over here. Wow. That shot no good. Nice scrambling. He gets the ball, gets two. Oh, Ty man. Nice block there. Looks like the senior's trying to slow up the pace. And now the court has shrunk. Both teams have to stay ahead of the three-point line. Fires that. That shot blocked. Meyer fires one. Hit off of a freshman, and that's one elimination. And it looks like it's a 2v1. Can they close it? Freshmen and sophomores getting loud. Ty fires one, that's no good. A really good duck there. And I believe they're saying that Maya is out. She stepped on her three-point line, and it's a 1-on-1. Can Ty clinch it for the seniors? This to the side dodgeball. The freshmen getting loud. The seniors getting loud. That shot. No one home. Did it hit him? Hey, that's all. It's so good. Wait. It hits. I'm in. Freshman winning. Are you kidding me? It hit all of his leg. And we've got some confusion. What an ending. Yeah, I believe right there it hit off his leg and he thought he blocked it. Oh man, as the freshman take it home. As both sides getting loud as we prepare for the junior dance.
If you want to come in, report to the middle of the gym. If you are not in the event, you need to be sitting in the future.
Thank you. All right, if you're not in, sit, junior sit. Sit down.
Thank you. Thank you. Modelo.
Oh my God.
Is the senior class.